Hi Shweta and Rasika, it's great to meet both of you and host you on She Rose. A little about She Rose, it's the first and largest women-only social network, which has especially been designed to, you know, fuel the goals and aspirations and dreams of millions of women in India and beyond. With that, I'd love to congratulate both of you on the second season of Mirzapur. All your fans on She Rose, including me, are very excited. So before this interview, we actually put out a call for questions in our community. And, you know, one of the most popular questions was, how has the lockdown been for both of you? And all your fans would love to know, how did you spend your time and what kept you sane?
Physical and mental health both are very important and both need to go hand in hand. Thanks to my husband, I started working out a lot. And that's when I realized that whenever I used to work out, I felt better about myself, about my body. It was not about fitting into clothes or, you know, having a certain kind of figure. But being healthy is the most important. So my eating has really improved because I was having ghar ka khana. And that made a difference not only to my physical looks, but also how I felt about myself.
Absolutely. I think that's a really powerful message, and it's wonderful that, you know, when you and your loved ones don't kill each other during such a time, it's really a positive thing. And over to you, Rasika, how's been your experience?
I think I started off in the lockdown feeling like I had come off shooting for a 10-day night schedule on Delhi Crime Season 2. So when I came back, I think for the first 20 days into lockdown, I was only sleeping. I was just recovering from sleep. Because night schedules can be very hard on actors. And I was just like, oh, now I can sleep for 10 hours. So I think I started off like that in the first, but very quickly, I think I was like, okay, now I have this time. Let me learn some new things. And then I crowded that time with so many new things to learn. So then suddenly I found myself not so free anymore. So there was a music class that I had joined. There was a cooking class that I was doing. So I was doing all those things that people post about on Instagram. And I was very happy to be learning a new skill finally. You know, every time I get some time off, I start learning how to sing. And to the absolute disgust of my neighbors and my husband. But I'm at it. You know, this is one thing I'm very dheet about. I'm like, even if I can't sing, I will learn. Also, I co-wrote a short film with my husband, which we shot entirely from home. That was in May. So we were in complete lockdown at that time. So it was just sort of a way to respond creatively to these times.
The next question I have is for you, Shweta. You know, we have a community member called Janya, who's a big fan of yours. She says that, you know, you've always played bold roles fearlessly and flawlessly. In fact, she thought that in the film Gone Kesh, she thought you were really 15 years old. And she almost had a cardiac arrest to discover you're a grown woman. So what is it that drives or attracts you to this this wonderful diversity of characters that you chose?
Her name is Janya, correct?
Janya, yes.
So first of all, thank you. Thank you so much. That means a lot. I think I'm drawn to characters who handle themselves well in a difficult situation. I like to be in difficult times, and that's why I think season one was exciting, Mirzapur. But what was most exciting was that season two will be a lot of madness, and it will be a lot of madness because of how season one ends. So that is what attracted me to Mirzapur. Be it Gone Kesh, I remember a lot of journalists had asked me ki aap dare nahi ki, you know, you aapko ek character karna tha aur baal nahi the, but that is what excites me. I think, and in fact, there was a poster behind me, which was my face. Tha, and I looked at myself and I thought, I'm looking very cute. So, mujhe aisa, I think ye jo physical appearance ka jo hume, market bechna chahti hai na, there is this idea of perfect. Ki lambe height achche hai, lambe baal achche hai, gori, chamdi achchi hai, ye sab bakwas hai. Yeah, agar if we buy into all of this nonsense, we are just giving money to these multinationals, and the idea of beauty is all here and here. So I like to do characters which I think all my characters make me a better person, and they are definitely very strong, and I really enjoy that. At the same time, I want to play a character which is not that strong, because I think I did a short film called Besan Ke Laddu. So, usme main aisa kuch tha ki main this bahu who is trying to impress her mother-in-law. And andar se I was dying, because I'm like, nahi, ye kyun? Like, why is she listening to what everybody else wants? Why is she not listening to herself? But that's when you have to realize that your characters are different from you.
You know, your character in the show experiences a lot of, you know, oppression, which is a fairly common dynamic in a patriarchal society. And, you know, within that framework, she's able to express her desires. And I've heard many women say that your character has really inspired them, because they sort of relate to it in many ways, right? So what is it that eventually makes her snap, and what's in store for her in the second season? Like, how do you see that being out? You'd love to have a peek.
So first, I have to share that when I read the script of season one, I was very excited about Beena, of course, as an actor, because it was very different from what I normally get offered. But also, I was very relieved to finally find a script in which they were exploring female desire, you know, where there was this character whose sexual desire was acknowledged. And you don't really find narratives like that. I mean, narratives around women, in which women have been victims of sexual violence, is a narrative that we are all comfortable with. Narratives where women are objectified is a narrative which we're very comfortable with. But desire is a narrative you're not comfortable with when it comes to women. But it's celebrated when it comes to men, you know. So I was very relieved to find a character who's acknowledged as a sexual being, you know. But at the same time, I think I was very heartbroken at how season one ends, because I was like, okay, so she is also exploited, you know, and the violence and the humiliation of that, I think, was very, I didn't want to see Beena like that, you know. And I think as an audience, when people watch that, I know that that people might feel the same. So I was when season two came about, I knew that it was going to be about revenge, but what I found nice was where it started, and the writer's very beautifully written a little journey in for her, where it starts from a point of the experience of of being violated and humiliated, and how she finds her Beena-ness again.
What's your advice for women when it comes to chasing dreams and dealing with rejection and setbacks? And how do you stay motivated in tough times and grounded in the times of success?
One thing that I want to tell everybody, which is again from my own personal journey, it's very important to know your dreams and to be vocal about it. Because when you respect your dreams, then people around you will respect that. For example, when I was getting married, a lot of people said, "Arey Shweta, itni shaadi kyun kar rahi hai? Career to abhi chalu ho raha hai." And after getting married, I was the busiest. In fact, both Rasika and I, we are married. I'm doing pretty well. So let the society not tell you ki age is a limit, height is a limit, skin color is a limit. Have your dream and go crazy about it. Be obsessed. As long as you're not hurting anybody, you're not harming anyone, please go for it. And sometimes you have to take that stand, because if you don't take it, you samne wala nahi dekh payega.
Being an actor is a good exercise in being grounded, because there's so much which pulls you up and there's so much that pulls you down also, that I think automatically you sort of remain in a space where you stop paying too much attention to either, you know. So because there are tons of people who are just waiting to tell you how you messed up at every single point, whether it's the way you look or whether it's the way you conduct yourself, where, whatever, you know. And there are tons of people who are waiting to pull you down, but there are tons of people who have been so generous with compliments and have constantly been encouraging you in your journey. So there's a mix of both, and I think that's what sort of keeps you in a space where you start getting start taking either too seriously.
Of course, watch Mirzapur season 2 on the 23rd October.
That's one piece of advice that we don't mind giving.
Absolutely, we will be binge watching it. So thank you so much, and it was lovely speaking to both of you, and the values that both of you have talked about are absolutely inspiring. And last but not the least, we would love to see you both on the Shiro's app. It's a women-only community and it's a safe space where you can talk about all kinds of stuff. All right? Thank you so much.
Sure. I look forward to exploring that.
All right. Bye-bye. And all the best.